kidding? I even know that it's Arcana. Oh, this is going to be nuts. 30.
Wow. All right.
He knows all magics all the time.
Yes.
I have one of these in my basement.
He just had it installed.
Yeah.
All right.
Impresses the ladies.
Have you seen my portal?
All right, the true answer resides out
it's
there.
It's like a hot tub. Like, you can sit halfway in the portal.
Your lower half just kind of tingles.
Yeah.
All right. Can we cue the first question, please?
What?
Oh, what?
Questions.
First one.
Oh.
Oh, we know what it is and you don't.
First question.
All right.
You see this?
No. Everyone text your vote to 25252. Vote space one.
No way.
All right, folks.
I can't read it.
Oh, we can't read it.
We can't read it?
No.
We'll give you more warning next time so you can get it.
In the twisting halls, the heroes find a portal to hell encrusted with gemstones. What must they do to activate the portal? A, they must perform the truffle shuffle.
Okay.
B, they must shed the blood of an ally. C, they must share their darkest secrets. Or D, one of them must swallow a gemstone.
They're delicious, I'm sure.
Like pop rocks.
All right, DM, are you ready for some answers?
What the deuce?
I didn't know you guys did any of this. This is rad.
We didn't do this.
Great.
No, I mean, we drew the picture, but man.
It's like we're really
bad. Are you ready for the answer?
Yeah.
Are we ready to put the results? Are we tabulating? Let's go ahead and throw the results up.
Thank God. Because I think the truffle shuffle was that fat kid from Goonies did. Yeah. And I know who would have been elected to do that.
I was going
to
make you guys act it out, too. All right. So Jim knows that in order to activate this circle, each of you must stand inside it and share your darkest secret.
Our character's darkest secret?
That's right.
Okay.
Your character's darkest secret.
Scott Kurtz's darkest secret.
And here's the catch, and Jim knows this because he rolled a 30.
I did.
That this darkest secret then becomes known to the person who created this circle.
That is so rad.
That's bullshit.
That is awesome stuff.
Yeah.
That turns my crank.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, Jim understands. So listen, guys, I'll show you how it works. Darkest secret, in the circle, not a big deal. I take a step in, deep breath. I magically darken my hair.
And it's called Jim Dark Magic's Just for Mage.
Oh!
Yes!
That's it, guys. Haven't told anyone that before. But
there is an explosion of fire in the circle, and Jim Dark Magic just sort of erupts into flame and disappears, and all that's left are a few floating embers.
Wow.
All right, so I'll see you guys later.
Woo! The eyes are wide. At that point.
Yes.
All right, Benjamin, take a deep breath. And, take a deep breath, steel myself, and I push Mr. Stinky into the portal.
All right, Mr. Stinky's standing on the circle.
Well.
Stinky is self-conscious about stink.
Up he goes. Nothing left but cinders.
Don't you want to go next?
Oh, I will. Don't worry. Okay. I'm right after you, buddy.
You're right after me? I step into the portal, and I try not to look you right in the eyes, and I say, I've embezzled at least 10%.
What?
Oh! Boom! And then nothing happens?
Nothing
and I go,
happens.
20%.
Still there.
25%.
You can take all those gems out now.
Yeah, yeah. It'd be funny if you walk to the portal and a single tear comes down and you go, I knew you were embezzling.
I'll enter the circle. And say that Acquisitions Incorporated is a partnership and between a brother and a sister. And the sister is really cool. And she went into a dungeon one time when I was very young, and I didn't follow after her. And I stayed outside, and she never came out.
Oh. Wow. Oh.
All right. None of you guys, by the way, heard that.
Yeah, I was going to say.
That's why I waited till last.
All right, you all appear together on a hellish plain, surrounded by jagged rocks, some of them the color of blood.
Blood.
You also see bubbling up from these jagged fumaroles.
What? I mean, right.
I don't know either.
No, yeah, fumaroles.
What's it? Kind of looks like a small volcano.
Yeah.
Oh.
Come on, Mike.
All right. Are these sort of belching gouts of acid that kind of drip?
PTSD? Is that... It still stings?
Yeah.
Why did it have to be acid pits?
It's called hell.
Couldn't it have been succubi?
And you start to make your way across this blasted landscape, and Jim gets really scared because he's getting all kinds of grit in his hair.
This is never going to come out.
And the
this
wind
is it.
Just,
this is just what my hair looks like now.
When the wind sort of rips through, it just feels like you're being torn apart by razor blades. It's just not fun at all.
Oh,
wow.
Why did we come here again?
I forget, actually. We should go back.
Blades.
Are we standing on a portal?
No, there's no portal on this side.
Okay.
Awesome.
All right.
So do we know which direction to go? Or do we? Is it just like vast in every direction?
It looks pretty vast, but you're kind of in the back of a box canyon, so you kind of know you're one course out. You can also see evidence of tracks in the dust that's sort of piled up in various places on the ground. And as you make your way up the trail, you start to see, after about a couple miles or so, some corpses lying in the dust. And they look like they were walking somewhere and didn't make it, and they've got shackles on their hands and shackles on their legs.
Poor.
Can we make a heal check to see what killed them?
Yeah.
Can I make a check to see if they have any loot on them?
Yeah. All right. You can make a perception check.
Yeah, I'm sure they have some designer shackles, Binwin.
I got a 5 on my heal.
I'm gonna walk around in a circle.
Okay.
I see that Jim is kneeling down in a very CSI way.
Yeah.
And it's embarrassing. So I follow up with my own heal check.
Okay.
CSI.
How'd you do on your perception check?
I did a 14.
All right.
21.
Okay, first thing you notice is that there are two of them, and they're dwarves.
Oh.
Yep. You can see that their beards have been shaved off.
What?
Oh.
Yeah.
This is the best. You guys should be here all the time when you play this game.
Wait.
That's what I like.
If we're doing this CSI style, then Binwin looks up and goes, looks like these guys had some years shaved off.
Yeah! Oh man. All right.
You can see they've also been branded with this fiendish-like brand. It kind of looks like a cattle brand on their backs.
I have a perception. I can check and see if I recognize that. I got a 19.
Wow.
And I can say my hilarious catchphrase. Yeah. How about 19? Does 19 work for you?
19 works. Well done. 19 works plenty. Yeah, you've seen this symbol before for a number. Basically, whenever the Ambershards start bagging slaves and bringing them to the Twisting Halls, they all seem to have these brands.
So I point at the brand and I go, slaves.
But they're dead, clearly.
Yeah, yeah.
And it looks like that they were bludgeoned to death.
Ooh, that's a bad way to go.
Probably they tried to get away or they were disobedient.
Chris, what was your childhood like?
He had a sister who went into a cave.
Too soon.
please continue with your.
All right.
As far as I know, autobiography. Like?
The slaves have been shaved. They've been shaved. I hate you, Dad. Where am I?
I stole that joke from Chris Stroud.
Yep. Right. The next thing you see as you make your way through this hellish plain, apart from the acid pits, are a little sharp to the nose, you begin to see this gigantic herd beast that looks fairly docile because it's just standing there chewing on blood rock.
It's like a hell cow?
It's like a gigantic behemoth. It looks just like that.
It's a triceratops.
It's an evil hell triceratops.
And there's fire coming out of its eyes.
Okay, so it's awesome. And that distinguishes it from a regular cow.
Yes.
That's rad.
Yes. And it's just eating like hard blood rock, and it kind of gives you a lazy look with its fiery eyes.
Nature check?
Yep.
Are you going to try to do some like Crocodile Dundee type shit?
Yeah, I sort of walk up real slow.
Yeah.
Twisting my hand back and forth, and I get a 5. It's not friendly.
It sort of looks at you. Bits of actual rubble sort of come out of its mouth and just sort of drop onto the ground.
Who's a pretty girl?
Crunch, 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 and it just sort of looks at you stupidly. But it does not attack.
Even on a 5.
I've tamed it. I've tamed this wild beast. He will now be my mount.
We will come back to you guys in a second.
Uh-oh.
Aofel.
Oh, that's me.
Damn.
You've got a bag over your head, and you're being marched across a fearsome landscape that you're just thankful you can't see, and your nose is picking up a very strong, powerful caustic odor that is familiar and just horrid.
I know what
and
it is.
You try to take your bag off, but you've got these shackles on, and you've got these leg irons on,
and
you're
humiliating.
Being poked and prodded by these, what you recognize, these voice-wise, to be dwarves.
Dwarves.
And there were at least 4 or 5 of you. But apparently, 2 of them tried to run off when they first arrived here, and it didn't sound like it went too well. But there is one other guy who's with you, and he's just sort of kind of leading the way. And all you can tell about him is that he's a human, but you haven't actually seen him because of the bag over your head.
Can I try to talk to him?
Absolutely.
Human. Human, can you hear me?
We love to be addressed by human.
Yeah. Because we are human.
Yeah.
Dude, you speak common.
A surfer?
You speak with a tongue I have not heard in many years. Did you go to San Dimas High School?
No way. I was totally raised in Hammerfest.
Yeah, what park?
Do you know where we are?
You been to Hammerfest High?